Bakersfield.com and the CSUB Roadrunners Digital Network. Live from the Dignity Health Studios in downtown Bakersfield, California.
Welcome into another edition of Roadrunner Rundown, the official program, CSUB Roadrunner Athletics. Corey Costello here with you. Hey, thanks so much for joining us on Bakersfield.com. We're live from the Dignity Health Studios in downtown Bakersfield and on demand as well at GoRunners.com. Hey, thanks for joining us. We've got a great show again planned as we're going to be talking a lot of volleyball today, and not specifically volleyball, sand volleyball. That's the kind of volleyball we're going to be talking. We're going to be one of the newest sports at CSUB and just had their first home match, so we'll talk about that. We have Mariah Alvidrez and Shayna Guitare in studio coming up a little bit later in the program. They are Bakersfield's number two pairing, and they were instrumental in the win over Oregon, so we'll chat with them coming up next. Also, in the following segment, we will talk some CSUB softball. Madison Bundy, a junior on the softball team, will join us on the show. She's in her second year here in Bakersfield after transferring from Oregon State. The Roadrunners are at home this weekend again in Western Athletic Conference play, hosting Grand Canyon. So we'll talk with Madison about the upcoming series. And also joining us in the last segment of the show, the man, he's got a lot of different distinctions now that he took the job at San Jose State, but we're going to have a Behind Enemy Lines segment featuring the first guest to appear on this show as a normal guest and as a Behind Enemy Lines segment guest. And I'm talking about our former volleyball assistant coach, now a head sand volleyball coach at San Jose State, Aaron Shepardson. He'll join us on the program on the phone in the last segment as his Spartans are coming to Bakersfield this Friday and Saturday to take on the Roadrunners in sand volleyball. So there's a couple more distinctions that we'll talk with Aaron about, but he is the first guy to be on this show in studio in the fall, and then in the spring, he's a Behind Enemy Lines segment guys. So we'll get to that coming up later on the program as well. But speaking of volleyball and sand volleyball, let's get to the highlights of Bakersfield's first home volleyball match as the Runners. Is that the beach? Wait, no. That is Bakersfield. Sand volleyball courts opening for the Runners against Oregon. First home match. Good crowd on hand last week as well for the opener. Everybody checking out the new facility as early action in the center court. Danica Youngblood, Sydney Haynes for CSUB against Martin Bett and Amanda Benson of Oregon. Early troubles for Bakersfield on the Oregon point via the block. Runners, though, get it back on the Haynes roll shot. More Oregon, though, with another kill coming up here as they win that on straight sets. On court two, Sarah Little and Hazel Perrins with a win over Serena Warner and Naya Crittenden. Pick it up in the action in the last set. 1-0 Bakersfield. The nice kill by Perrins. Then later in the set, a nice couple of digs from Perrin coming up for the road. There's one there. And also sets up Little for the upcoming shot and the point as the Roadrunners will set it up here, get it back over, and then we'll force a, pretty much an Oregon error right there for the point. Runners set point. They get it to fall on the ace. We're tied 1-1 in the team duel. Second session getting underway. Oregon would get match number three at the three position in straight sets. Then the number two pairing coming up right here as they introduce the new starters, the 1-2-3 pairs. Picking up action in the number two pairs, Mariah Alvidrez, Shayna Guitare, just dominant the kill there. Then Alvidrez coming up for the Roadrunners with the ace as they win the first set handily. Not much more luck for Oregon. How can you have any luck with Alvidrez and Guitare making plays like that? Great teamwork, great finish. Runners win in straight sets there. As a good duel should, it comes down to number one match. All eyes on center court. Molly O'Hagan and Deborah Araju against Liz Brenner and Tatum Norton. Runners took the first set 21-11. Second set action, Araju with the kill there. Then O'Hagan a little long, and then as a close bat on this set, but Oregon turns the corner, wins 17-15. They win second set 21-19. Third and final set, play to 15. Last match to decide the duel. No problem for Araju and O'Hagan. Good match, but CSUB controls with a couple of nice shots. As there's another one there. Match point, nice teamwork by Bakersfield. Well, not quite match point. You'll see a few more of the good shots going down for the Roadrunners. And O'Hagan and Araju. Here comes match point. Araju coming up with the finishing touch for the Roadrunners. O'Hagan the bump set. Araju the finish. Bakersfield wins 3-2, beating Oregon in the duel.
So, you know, we've been waiting for this first home game for so long, and we've been working so hard, and we had a great crowd. So it's awesome that we were able to come out here and beat a Pac-12 school in our first home match. It's been a long process getting this together, and it looks absolutely amazing. We're so happy. We're very proud of this facility. I think we have one of the best facilities around, and we appreciate all the hard work that's been put into this. So it's a great place to play, and it's a great place to come watch us play.
It's been like 2 years in the making, so it's really awesome that we came out here. We had a lot of fans to support us, and we got a win out of it. So.
And I'm like, nice. Getting a win over a great Oregon team, yeah, that's awesome. I'm so proud of these girls. They set up the facility. They worked hard, you know, at practice. I've given them challenges at practice, and they've gone after it, and they've just made me so proud, you know, with all their hard work and coming out here today. And just there's lots of adversity. Whenever you play an Oregon team, they're amazing athletes and great competitors. So just the opportunity to play them is superb. But then to actually, you know, get a win is really, really cool.
So how about that? Bakersfield beats the Ducks 3-2 in the new court opening. Araju and O'Hagan with the number one win. Shayna Guitare, Mariah, Alvidrez made quick work of their opponents as well. They'll join us in the next show segment. If you missed the first home match, not to worry. Roadrunners have two this weekend. They will be hosting San Jose State on Friday at 4 p.m. and USC on Saturday at 2 p.m. Admission is free for the sand volleyball event. So a couple matches coming up for Bakersfield as they continue their new sand volleyball courts, opening them up in grand fashion, San Jose State this weekend, along with USC as well. Well, the Roadrunner baseball team in action this past week. They had 4 games this past week. Let's start with a non-conference matchup against UC Irvine on Tuesday. We'll head to Hart Field and the highlights of Tuesday's matchup. Bakersfield taking an early 4-run lead as Max Carter extends the third inning, sets the table there with the double as this one rolls into the right field corner and Carter gets to second base, and then Oscar Sinai at the plate for the Roadrunner. This was a long inning for UC Irvine as this roller to shortstop gets booted into the outfield, so that will score a run. Jordy Hines scoring for CSUB. Then the second error of the inning coming up on this next play and this throw from the shortstop as well. Going to draw the first baseman off the bag. Another run scores. Then Garrett Pierce draws a walk for Bakersfield as he coming up right here. Garrett Pierce will load the bases. As a wild game started with one umpire because of traffic on the 5. Next batter, Alan Gwynn, goes up the middle to give CSUB a 3-0 lead as Logan Trowbridge comes into, or actually Sinai should score. Then Logan Trowbridge at the plate as Gwynn delivers on the RBI. Trowbridge does the same as that one will sneak through. Nowhere to go. The play at the plate, though, in time. That ends the inning, but a run did score. Irvine, next inning, though, they score 3. They also try to get sneaky themselves, but to no avail as one out recorded there. Back at home, and you're out as well. But they tied in the 5th, tied at 4-4. Then the runners couldn't bring them in as Trowbridge strikes out. Guspeth goes down swinging as well. Solomon Williams pops out to left. The CSUB strands 11 base runners in the game, and they lose it 7-4 to UC Irvine. So Bakersfield dropping the non-conference matchup last Tuesday. Then they went on the road against Utah Valley. Good start on Friday, a 10-4 victory for Bakersfield in the series. Miles Jones, 3 hits to lead the runners. Taylor Aikenhead, another win on the bump for CSUB. Then it kind of went south again. The hitting just sort of abandoned Bakersfield once again. Utah Valley wins the first game of Saturday's doubleheader 4-1, and then they come back and they beat the runners as well in game number 2 of the doubleheader. So they take the series from Bakersfield as runners fell 4-2 in the nightcap. They dropped the series to the Wolverines. Bakersfield now 4-5 in conference play. Here's what's coming up. A nationally ranked week for the runners, and it will be capped off this weekend. They will go to Norman, Oklahoma to take on Oklahoma Friday at 6 p.m. Central Time. They will start that series in Norman, and Saturday and Sunday at 2 p.m. in Norman as well. So Bakersfield, what a weekend that's going to be for the Roadrunners as they go on the road to the University of Oklahoma this weekend for their baseball series. On to CSUB softball. They had conference play going on this weekend as well, and the Roadrunners home to Utah Valley. Let's take you out there to Friday's action. Bakersfield opening conference play. Ladies ready to go, and for conference play, down 2-0 early, but in the second, CSUB gets one back. RBI double by Sydney Raber. Bakersfield will make it a one-run game. Wolverines, though, right back at it in the third as Dynasty Luvai with the RBI double. Wolverines then go up 3-1. Defensive problem for Bakersfield as well. Four errors in the first four innings. That one should have ended the inning as it is dropped. Another run comes across for Utah Valley. Bakersfield gets out of the inning on the next play on the chopper to third base. Runners threatening again in the fourth, but Carissa Vega strikes out on a check swing. Madison Bundy then hits it right on the screws, but right to the left fielder before Ashley Carter singled over to third. Tying run on base, but a pop-up here to end the inning. Runners fall in Friday's WAC opener 4-1, and that was on Friday's game and Bakersfield. And then on Saturday, not much more luck for Bakersfield as they dropped the first game 9-4, and they dropped the second game 4-3 as well in Western Athletic Conference play. So Roadrunners will host, trying to get back on track in softball. They will host Grand Canyon this weekend at the softball complex, Friday at 2, Saturday at 1, and it's actually a doubleheader Saturday at 1 and about 4 o'clock-ish for the second game on Saturday as well. So the Roadrunners trying to get back on track. We'll talk with Madison Bundy coming up in the next segment of the program as well, as we talk some, or the next two segments from now, I should say, bottom of the hour, we'll talk with Madison Bundy about the Runners' upcoming series against Grand Canyon. But when we come back, we're going to talk some more sand volleyball. And that number two team you saw in the highlights, they're dominating their opponents and won in straight sets. Mariah Alvidrez, Shayna Guitare will join us next on the program. So stick around for that. We'll be back with Mariah and Shayna. This is Roadrunner Rundown.
Introducing TBC Mobile from the Bakersfield, California. The most complete news, sports, weather, video, opinion, and lifestyle coverage in Bakersfield and Kern County. It's the easiest way to stay up to date on all things local while on the go. Read it on your smartphone or tablet. Download now by searching Bakersfield, California in the Apple, Google, and Amazon app stores. Kern Business Journal contains news and information from local business leaders and organizations. Topics include agriculture, health and medical, energy, real estate, and more. Visit KernBusinessJournal.com to find out how to subscribe or where to pick up a free copy. To inquire about advertising in the bi-monthly business journal, call 395-7586. Find us online on Facebook and Twitter, as well as on KernBusinessJournal.com.
Brave and bold, silver and gold.
We're on a mission. Aggie up.
Our country just got a whole lot bigger.
Mighty Wolverines of UVU.
Join the herd. Lopes up.
Bold moves, big season, grew up.
We are the new gold standard.
We will be champions.
We are the Western Athletic Conference.
Save 50 to 90% with the Bakersfield Californian's Daily Deal featured on Bakersfield.com. A daily deal is offered each weekday on services from local restaurants, dry cleaners, health and beauty services, retail shops, and local activities for the entire family. The Daily Deal is 100% local. Find these amazing deals only at dailydeal.bakersfield.com.
The Roadrunner Scholarship Fund creates educational opportunities for over 300 student-athletes at CSUB. By becoming a member and donating to the Roadrunner Scholarship Fund, you're not only helping the Roadrunners fund the scholarship needs of our teams, you're investing in the future. The Roadrunner Scholarship Fund isn't just developing student-athletes. We're developing tomorrow's leaders from lessons learned during competition. For more information, log on to gorunners.com/donate and become a member of the Roadrunner Scholarship Fund.
Welcome back into Roadrunner Rundown. Thanks so much for joining us on the program. By the way, still to come on the show, we'll talk some softball with Madison Bundy, CSUB junior. And also on the program, we're going to have the first ever guest to appear both in studio and as a Behind Enemy Lines segment guest. Our former volleyball coach, Aaron Shepardson, will join us on the phone. He's coming back this weekend to play sand volleyball against these ladies right here in studio. This is the number two partnership, the number two duo on the Roadrunner Sand Volleyball Club, and Shayna Guitare and Mariah Alvidrez. Ladies, thanks for joining us. How you doing?
Good. How are you?
Good. Yeah. How are you?
Good. Good. Well, thanks for joining us. Congratulations on the wins this past week against Oregon. You guys, we showed some of the highlights. You guys just pretty much dominated.
It was a really fun game.
Yeah. So much fun, and kind of a shame. I figured they would have been a little bit better and would have put up a fight, but yeah, we had a lot of fun that game.
Yeah, and you guys look great. And this is your, Mariah, this is your second season in the sand. And how has this year been different from, you know, the time you guys started training, having 1 year of sand volleyball in your background already?
It's been a lot different. I feel like this year we've worked on more technical stuff and really working on getting things right rather than just playing a lot and getting experience. We have our experience under us now, and so it's the technical stuff that really matters.
Shane, is the same thing. I mean, 1 year already. I mean, has that helped this season?
Yeah, I think drastically. I mean, we had Olivia come in. We've worked a lot on technique, form, strategy, stuff like that, and it's really shown an improvement this year, I think.
What's it been like to have your own facility to practice at this year, as opposed to dragging things down to Truxton?
And oh, absolutely incredible. Such a time saver, life saver. I mean, it's good to be able to get used to, like, an environment, you know, have something stable.
Well, Mariah, you're a Bakersfield kid. I mean, to have courts like this on campus in Bakersfield, right? That's got to definitely kind of help the program and the sport to have those courts available in town.
Definitely. It's night and day from last year, that's for sure. And it's great to have that at home. Like, there are courts, and it's nice to be able to feel comfortable in our own area.
And I know you guys have worked on these quite a bit, but I've seen the courts. I saw them built and evolved. But then I got there on last Wednesday, and I saw the game day environment, the people, and I'm like, wow, this is awesome. I mean, were you guys kind of shocked too?
Oh, I mean, I kept telling Mariah, I was like, I can't believe we're having a home game. I can't believe we're having a home game. And then when it all, like, came together, when we had everything set up, I was like, wow, we have an incredible facility. It really came together. It shocked me. I really liked it.
How does it stack up to other facilities? I mean, I've seen pictures, but you guys have been to them. How does it stack up?
Oh, I think ours is by far the best. Okay. And I'm not just saying that because it's ours. Yeah. But, I mean, all the other places, they're, like, feel so, like, small and compact and, like, kind of just were put there because that's the extra space that they have. But ours is pretty legit.
Yeah, I mean, I've driven by USC's, and I'm familiar with that area of campus, and it's a great set of courts, but they literally found the smallest piece of postage stamp they could to fit it on campus. Mm-hmm. And it's, you know, you hit a ball too far, it goes onto Olympic Avenue or whatever it is. It's getting hit by a car. So obviously, and the facility is great. Now, you guys were partners last season as well. You were 10 and 12. Mariah, how has this partnership kind of evolved from year one to year two?
Well, I think last year we had a lot of great chemistry, and we kind of were both, well, I was kind of just going into this blindly, but she has had some experience just from back home, and I think we've grown a lot, and we kind of just know where each other are on the court a lot, and it just works great.
And Shayna, it seemed like you guys, when I was, you know, filming these highlights and watching you guys play, there's more communication with your team probably than any. You guys talk the most. Is that a huge part of it?
I think it has a lot to do with it. Like, we know how to work with each other. We know how to communicate with each other. And, I mean, definitely having this as our second year together, I think, has helped.
Yeah.
But definitely talking out on the court and communicating about, like, everything not only keeps, like, the positive energy going, the strategy going, like the focus. But I think communication is key.
And you guys are such like positive, bubbly personality people. You never get mad at each other on the court, though, do you?
Sometimes.
So, we have ways of.
Yeah. It's more of a joking matter than like getting onto each other about it. We joke about it, and then we're fine.
Okay. Yeah. So if you miss one, it's like, yeah, nice effort there. Could have seen a little more of that, huh?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. That works. Shayna Guitare, Mariah Alvidrez joining us here on Roadrunner Rundown. Now, and you brought it up a little bit, Mariah, but do you have to know what your partner is thinking and know where they're going to be when your back's to them and stuff like that?
I wouldn't say you'd have to know. You just kind of have to trust them. Yeah. Like trust that they know their job, what their job is, and then that you're going to get your job done too.
There you go. Now, you both played multiple sports in high school and college. Mariah, you played volleyball, soccer, and softball, even played college soccer, and then now sand volleyball. Shayna, you played volleyball, soccer, water polo, ran track in high school as well. Did I miss anything? No. And now you're playing sand volleyball. So big question for the both of you. Where does sand volleyball sort of rank in your, you know, fun sports to play?
Definitely top two.
Top two. Yeah. Okay. Yep.
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Top two.
Yeah. For me, sand volleyball is kind of like my life. I really enjoy sand volleyball. Yeah. So I have fun playing all sports, but sand volleyball is definitely up there.
And is there maybe, and it seems like it's no coincidence that you have to be a good athlete to be a good sand volleyball player. I mean, sometimes really good indoor players don't play so well in the sand because they're just strictly indoor volleyball players. So, it's no coincidence that you have to have several different skills.
Definitely. Yeah. I think sand is completely different than indoor volleyball, and a lot of people don't realize that, but it is. It's really hard.
Well, just sometimes. Try to run on that stuff.
Yeah, exactly.
Trying to run,
you
move,
experienced
jump.
It. Yeah. It was pretty hard.
I did, yes, to a overwhelming failure. I experienced.
You did pretty well.
But it was a lot of fun just to get out there, and I hurt myself, which was good. I mean, I did.
Experienced the full effect.
I experienced the full effect. Do you ever have that happen to you? I fell down and like bruised a rib because I landed on a little pile of sand.
Sometimes.
Did that happen to you guys?
Sometimes.
Or are you just that much
I get
better?
More like scrapes from just diving so much.
Yeah.
But,
well, yeah. I mean, yeah, so that's because you guys know how to dive properly. Me, not so much. When it comes to accomplishment, I mean, Shayna, is there maybe more of an accomplishment in sand volleyball because it's just you two? I mean, it's a team effort, but it's kind of a small team effort. I mean, so do you feel like you're more a part of it because it's only you two on the court?
In certain ways, yeah. I mean, like you said, it is like a smaller team. Like, although there is a large team effort, there's a smaller team. And so I do think, you know, like, accomplishment improvement comes from that.
And I know you guys have never been like shy on celebrating. No. You get to celebrate even more in sand though, because it's just you two. I mean, so you get a little more fist pumping, a little more screaming.
Yeah, definitely. This one for sure.
I get pretty excited sometimes.
Hey, but that's good. That's what it's there for. Now you guys are back at home this weekend, taking on San Jose State. Shep back in town with his new squad, head coach of the Spartans, your coach last year. How excited are you about his return?
Excited to bring it to him.
I agree.
Just show him what we become now.
Well, and that's got to be kind of cool because it is kind of a showcase for you because he helped really start the program last year and was instrumental in getting the facility rolling as well. So now you can be like, here's what you built. Boom.
Yep.
Yeah.
All right. There you go. Now, he had a lot to do with the facility and the program and obviously getting this thing on track. But you know, when you look at this match, I mean, it's just for you. It's just you got to put that aside, though, right? Mm-hmm. And just say, hey, we just need to play and beat San Jose State.
Right. Yeah. Exactly. Yeah.
And have you seen anything about their number two pairing you're going to see yet? Or
no, we've just seen like team stats and whatnot, but nothing individually about their second team. Mm-hmm.
Is it tough to prepare? Because I know in indoor there's so many stats and analytics and stuff. You can all break it down, but in the sand, I mean, it's mostly just team scores, and that's all you see. So is it tough to kind of – do you have to more focus on your game as opposed to scouting your opponent?
I'd say our game's most important, but we do scout them and see their tendencies and shots and where they like to go. But we kind of just go into it and problem solve, really. Yeah. That's all we can do.
Excellent. Yeah. And Mariah, you're a redshirt. You have another year of eligibility left, so you're returning next season, right? This is your junior year and eligibility. How's the major stuff going for you?
Pretty good.
Schoolwork, yeah?
Yeah. I mean, I feel I'm almost done, so that's exciting, but I'm still excited that I still have another year left.
Absolutely. And Shayna, you're a senior.
I'm
you're
a senior.
Getting ready to graduate? You're graduating
yep.
in the spring?
Graduating in the spring.
Good news. Kinesiology still?
Yep.
The major?
Yeah.
What are the plans after college?
I'm going to grad school.
Okay.
Going to Southern California University of Health Science.
Oh,
down
okay.
in Whittier.
Nice. Mm-hmm. And what are the career plans maybe?
Sports med chiropractor.
Oh, nice. So good. So when I dive
I can fix
and
you.
Corey versus and like knock a rib out of whack. You can fix me.
I sure can.
That sounds good. Well, ladies, hey, thanks so much for joining us. Congrats on a good start to the year. And San Jose State, USC this weekend. You played USC a lot, so you kind of hoping – you're looking at that one, too, going, okay,
oh.
we need
oh,
to take
yeah.
a step up.
Going
to
take it to them.
yeah. Last match was pretty good, so
yeah.
they better be ready.
Awesome. Yeah. No, it sounds good, and this program's taking big strides, and you guys have been a big part of it. Congrats on that, and we will see you this weekend at the facility.
Okay. Thank
we
you very much.
We still got to come up with a name, though. We were talking about that with Molly last week. So we got to come up with a name. There's
yeah,
no
we
name
do.
To the courts yet.
No.
So
no.
She was trying to name it after me, which I'm all for, but I really had nothing to do with it, so I'd feel bad stealing anybody's thunder. So anyway, we'll see you this weekend at the courts. Good luck.
Okay. Sounds good.
Thank you.
All right, we're going to step away, folks. When we come back, we're going to talk some softball. Madison Bundy will join us in studio. Roadrunner is hosting Grand Canyon this weekend in a conference series. Back after this, this is Roadrunner Rundown.
Introducing TBC Mobile from the Bakersfield, California. The most complete news, sports, weather, video, opinion, and lifestyle coverage in Bakersfield and Kern County. It's the easiest way to stay up to date on all things local while on the go. Read it on your smartphone or tablet. Download now by searching Bakersfield, California in the Apple, Google, and Amazon app stores.
Save 50 to 90% with the Bakersfield Californian's Daily Deal featured on Bakersfield.com. A daily deal is offered each weekday on services from local restaurants, dry cleaners, health and beauty services, retail shops, and local activities for the entire family. The daily deal is 100% local. Find these amazing deals only at dailydeal.bakersfield.com.
The Bakersfield Californian is a great read on the iPad. But did you know that the Bakersfield Californian is available on your Kindle Fire? Or how about Google's Nexus 7? The Nook? You bet. You can also read a full replica of the newspaper on your Android-powered smartphone, on Apple's iPhone, or on your laptop. We have a solution for any device. E-Edition is free for subscribers, or just $7.99 a month. The Bakersfield Californian. We're everywhere and anytime. Subscribe today. Bakersfield.com.
Kern Business Journal contains news and information from local business leaders and organizations. Topics include agriculture, health and medical, energy, real estate, and more. Visit KernBusinessJournal.com to find out how to subscribe or where to pick up a free copy. To inquire about advertising in the bi-monthly Business Journal, call 395-7586. Find us online on Facebook and Twitter, as well as on KernBusinessJournal.com.
The Roadrunner Scholarship Fund creates educational opportunities for over 300 student-athletes at CSUB. By becoming a member and donating to the Roadrunner Scholarship Fund, you're not only helping the Roadrunners fund the scholarship needs of our teams, you're investing in the future. The Roadrunner Scholarship Fund isn't just developing student-athletes. We're developing tomorrow's leaders from lessons learned during competition. For more information, log on to gorunners.com/donate and become a member of the Roadrunner Scholarship Fund.
Hey, welcome back into Roadrunner Rundown. My thanks to Mariah Alvidrez, Shayna Guitare for joining us in the last segment. CSUB Sand Volleyball. They're the number two pairing, but they've been playing very well and kind of. It's just great to see that team dynamic amongst two student athletes who have got to, you know, compete with each other every single match. So Sand Volleyball this weekend at home, they will take on San Jose State 4 o'clock on Friday, and then again back at 1 o'clock on Saturday against USC at the Sand Volleyball facility, to be named later. That's what we'll go with. But speaking of being at home this weekend, CSUB Softball is at home this weekend once again, hosting Grand Canyon at the softball complex. And joining us now on the program is junior Madison Bundy. Madison, thanks for joining us. How you doing?
I'm pretty good. Thank you for having me.
Well, you know, tough weekend last weekend. You guys, another set of close losses, and that's been kind of the story all year. How's the team kind of feeling as you get ready to bounce back with another conference series this weekend?
I think we're a little disappointed after this weekend, but I think that it was definitely a learning experience, and knowing that we're going to play a team three games in a row, we can learn a lot from our opponents and just use that each and every game to help us, create something and take a win out of it. So
how different was it this year? Now, last year in conference play, you played two doubleheaders.
Yeah.
Friday, Saturday, or Saturday, Sunday, however it went. And so this year you're going a Friday game and a Saturday doubleheader. And it's a three-game series, so there's going to be a clear winner. Is that kind of a different dynamic this year?
It's a little different, but I think we're all pretty excited that it's a clear and set winner, because taking two games from a team is good, but we want to get all three. So, and last year splitting a series, it just wasn't as satisfying as knowing that you took, two out of the three or all three.
How tough was back-to-back doubleheaders? That seemed like a brutal schedule.
It was pretty brutal. It was pretty brutal because we knew, that Saturday we have two games and then we wake right back up and we have two more games. So it was pretty tough. But
well, yeah, the three-game series now through the whack, much better. Now you're hitting .269 this season. 10 RBIs, a home run, 7 doubles. Pretty good start given the tough schedule you guys had, and obviously some pretty tough pitchers. You're pretty happy with the way that, you've kind of started the year?
I'm happy with it. I think that I always, I'm always disappointed when I don't go 3-for-3 or 4-for-4, but yeah, I'm happy with the contribution that I'm making, and I think that I would love to make some improvements, but yeah.
Well, I was looking at the box score from this weekend. I think you were 1-for-3 in every game.
Yeah.
So, you hit, break down to .333. You hit that, that's Hall of Fame numbers in baseball, softball. I mean, that gets you places, 1-for-3. Now, looking at your team, we talked about this, but so many close one-run losses. You're into conference play now. Do you kind of feel that things are coming together a little bit as you play more games in conference?
Yeah, I think that things are coming together. We're having more cylinders fire at one time. And I think that the further, we push and the harder we play, I think that it's just going to all come together. And I think we're on that upswing right now. I don't think that there will be another this past weekend. I think we're definitely moving forward.
And it seems in those close games, and it seems like the series, the team hasn't had those games where everything clicks. It's either great pitching performance and not a lot of run support or hitting, or you break out for a lot of runs, but so is the other team because you're not pitching or playing, defense too well. So it just seems like, has it seemed like that to you as well as a player, where you just haven't had those games where everything has been in line?
Yeah, I think that we all kind of recognize that, and that's what's frustrating about it, because these close games, we know that we should be taking them, but different aspects aren't clicking. But I think that it's coming together better, and I think that we're gonna mesh more and more. And I don't think that it'll be too much of a problem in the future.
And you had a couple of injuries, I know, early in the season.
Yeah,
kind of knocked a few key players out. Have you seen people? Have you kind of settled on those roles as people have tried to fill in? And has that had an effect as well?
I don't think that it's had an effect. I think that everyone has contributed any way that they can, and I think that we've filled the roles that we needed to fill due to the injuries, mm-hmm. and I think that the people that have picked up those roles have done a great job, and when they come back, I think that they're going to contribute any way that they can also, and Yeah, so I don't.
No, absolutely. I know that was a couple of huge blows early.
But
it seems like people have stepped up and put up pretty good numbers. Now, you came here after a year at Oregon State, made the switch to Bakersfield. What kind of prompted you to say, hey, that's the program that I want to go and finish my career out at?
I think that I just felt it, and I knew in my gut that this is where I wanted to be. I knew with the coaching style, I knew the program, it was the type of program I wanted to be in.
Yeah.
Going after wins and going, trying to go to regionals and being competitive. And that's really just what I wanted, and it fit my personality. So it was an easy choice.
And it seems like the program's been improving a little bit every year, not only on the field, but even just – and I went to the softball complex, last week for the first time since the improvements, press box and concrete and new seating. And it just seems like now your guys' dugouts are still 4 miles away from home plate. But other than that, I mean, it seems like the program's taken a few steps in that regard, too. And that stuff looks good on the surface.
Yeah, definitely. I think that there can always be improvements, but we're definitely taking pride in the steps that have been made with our field. And we're very appreciative of everything.
And the field, the field looks beautiful, too. I mean, the infield, the grass is perfect. And last year it got kind of rough. It looks great. I mean, it just seems like all that stuff is, is looking top-notch now.
Yeah, it's coming together. And everyone's worked really hard and to get it all together. And so I think that everything's looking pretty good. Everything's going in the right direction.
And you guys 0-3 to start the conference play, but still a lot of conference games to go and the conference tournament to decide who even goes to regionals. So you're kind of confident that this team can still make a run at, a league title?
Yeah, definitely. I have no doubt that we're going to come out strong the next few weekends, and we're going to finish out the season, and we're going to take that WAC tournament. I have no doubt in our team and anything like that.
There you go. Well, that's a good statement. Now, baseball season opened yesterday officially. Now, you're from Washington, but that doesn't necessarily make you a Mariners fan, right?
No, it doesn't.
Really? I thought that was just like you had to do that. Like,
I know. Everyone says that. Well, you're a Mariners fan. No, I'm not really, but I just enjoy watching baseball, and I don't have a favorite team.
Okay. Yeah. Any specific players that you...
No, not really. It's kind of weird, but I don't. I've been to an Angels game and a Mariners game and a Rockies game, and I've been all over. I like the stadium, so I pick by the stadium, I guess.
I'm a lot like that. Now I'm an Oakland Athletics fan since I was a kid. Lived in San Diego for 4 years, and that was the year the Padres made the World Series in 1998. So I went to tons of Padres games over a 4 year span. So I'm a Padres fan too.
Yeah.
And then a couple years ago we went to visit Wrigley and go see U.S. Cellular Field where the White Sox play. We saw games there and games in Milwaukee. So I've got like Cubs shirts now. I got White Sox shirts. I got a Brewers hat. It's like all these places I visit. Yeah, I dig stadiums too. How many have you been to?
I went to a few on the East Coast too. So when I was younger, but probably about six.
Okay.
That's about where
I think I'm about there. Right about now.
Yeah.
So, yeah. I'm in that ballpark. No pun intended. About six of them visited. By the way, I would suggest now Wrigley Field is awesome, and so is Miller Park in Milwaukee. But the best smelling ballpark in America is U.S. Cellular where the White Sox play.
Really?
Somehow, like, all the food that they're in, it's Chicago, so the food's fantastic.
Yeah.
That they're all grilling and stuff just wafts into the stadium, and so you're surrounded by pleasant. You're surrounded by pleasantness. So
just makes the game that much better.
Yes, put that on your list
will.
For sure. Now, it also your bio also says you played soccer and basketball in high school.
Yes.
What? Now, I take it you were, you probably went to a small school. That's why you had to play a bunch of sports.
Yeah, I went to a school about 800 lesson.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So it was like required if you wanted to play one sport, you had to play several others. I went to the same size school, and yes, multi. So why? I mean, I know you're listed at like 5'5", so I take it basketball was out for you at the next level, right?
Yeah.
But why? Other than the fact that you put up monster numbers in high school as a softball player, why did you choose to go with softball?
I felt the best chance with my abilities. And I enjoyed soccer, but let's be honest, I didn't really want to run too much. And I didn't really see my skills developing like I did in softball.
Yeah.
So I just saw it and I took it and ran with it, basically. I thought that I was doing pretty well, and I just and all of my teammates around me were doing the same thing. Yeah. So
no, big time numbers in high school and now here in Bakersfield. What's your major? How's that going?
My major is public policy administration.
Okay.
And it's going good. I'm set to graduate on time and
nice.
Everything. Yeah.
What's the game plan after college?
I'm deciding if I want to get my master's in public policy administration or if I want to dip my feet in law school.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah.
So public policy administration and law school could mean, like, you could be a politician. Is there any thought about that?
That a lot of people think that, but that's not what I want to do.
You can be a politician, a lawyer, or an athletics director is how that works.
Sort of, yeah, but I'm not sure. I don't even know if I want to go to law school because I want to be a lawyer or if I just want to have it kind of in my back pocket.
No, a lot of people, you can go to law school and you become an athletic director. You can work in compliance in college athletics. And we've got people on staff that have law degrees.
Yeah.
And they're much smarter than I am. So I would say go get it. This weekend, Grand Canyon coming in. What have you seen out of that team? What are you expecting out of them this weekend here at the softball complex?
We're just going to take it and not look at who we're playing, but just know that they're going to provide three good games for us, and we're going to just give it right back to them. I don't think that it matters, who we're playing, but know each team is good and that we're going to give them a fight. So.
There you go. That's all you can do is keep on fighting as you continue in Western Athletic Conference play. Madison Bundy here on Roadrunner Rundown. Hey, thanks so much for joining us. Good luck this weekend.
Thank you so much.
And we'll keep tabs on you and up to and chat with you again soon.
Perfect. Thank you.
All right. Madison Bundy here on Roadrunner Rundown. Bakersfield hosts Grand Canyon this weekend at the softball complex. First game Friday at 2 o'clock. We're going to step away and take a break. When we come back, we're going to enter our Behind Enemy Lines segment with the first guest to ever appear on this show as a regular guest, and then later in the season, a Behind Enemy Lines guest. That's Aaron Shepardson, our former volleyball coach, and now the head sand volleyball coach at San Jose State. He's joining us on the program next as we preview this weekend's matchup, Bakersfield and San Jose State at the sand volleyball court. So that's coming up next. Stick around. We shall be back. This is Roadrunner Rundown.
The Bakersfield Californian is a great read on the iPad, but did you know that the Bakersfield Californian is available on your Kindle Fire? Or how about Google's Nexus 7? The Nook? You bet. You can also read a full replica of the newspaper on your Android-powered smartphone, on Apple's iPhone, or on your laptop. We have a solution for any device. E-Edition is free for subscribers, or just $7.99 a month. The Bakersfield Californian. We're everywhere and anytime. Subscribe today. Bakersfield.com.
Kern Business Journal contains news and information from local business leaders and organizations. Topics include agriculture, health and medical, energy, real estate, and more. Visit KernBusinessJournal.com to find out how to subscribe or where to pick up a free copy. To inquire about advertising in the bi-monthly Business Journal, call 395-7586. Find us online on Facebook and Twitter, as well as on KernBusinessJournal.com.
I'm Lisa Kirsch, coming up Wednesday for you on Live Well, Senior Fitness with a Certified Personal Trainer. We're also exploring 55-plus living communities with a Senior Real Estate Specialist. Our Mommy Roundtable is coming back by popular demand. This time we are focusing on surviving and thriving for empty nesters. These topics and much more coming up for you Wednesday on Live Well, only on Bakersfield.com.
Save 50 to 90% with the Bakersfield Californian's Daily Deal featured on Bakersfield.com. A daily deal is offered each weekday on services from local restaurants, dry cleaners, health and beauty services, retail shops, and local activities for the entire family. The daily deal is 100% local. Find these amazing deals only at dailydeal.bakersfield.com.
The Roadrunner Scholarship Fund creates educational opportunities for over 300 student-athletes at CSUB. By becoming a member and donating to the Roadrunner Scholarship Fund, you're not only helping the Roadrunners fund the scholarship needs of our teams, you're investing in the future. The Roadrunner Scholarship Fund isn't just developing student-athletes. We're developing tomorrow's leaders from lessons learned during competition. For more information, log on to gorunners.com/donate and become a member of the Roadrunner Scholarship Fund.
Welcome back in. Final segment of Roadrunner Rundown. Thanks so much for joining us on the program. My thanks to Madison Bundy, CSUB softball, joining us in the last segment. And prior to that, CSUB sand volleyball number two pairing, Mariah Alvidrez and Shayna Guitare, joining us in studio as well. So thank them and the Roadrunners at home. A couple of home duels this weekend. San Jose State on Friday, USC on Saturday. And our next guest has a couple different distinctions. One, as I mentioned earlier, the one and only guest to appear both in studio as a normal guest and now as a guest on our Behind Enemy Lines segment. And he also is probably the only man in America to lead two different first-year sand volleyball programs in consecutive seasons. So that sounds about right. We welcome to the program now. He is now head coach of the sand volleyball program at San Jose State, our good friend Aaron Shepardson. Aaron, good to talk to you again. How you doing?
Hey, Corey. Thanks for having me. And it's nice to know that I've reached historical footnote status.
Exactly. You are a historical footnote in sand volleyball. And for this show, too. Like I said, you're the only guy, I think, who's been in studio and on the phone as a Behind Enemy Lines segment guest. So you got that going for you, too.
Yeah, thanks a lot. No, it's great to be here.
Well, first of all, you're again, for the second year in a row, working with a first-year program. So has it kind of been like deja vu for you as you get San Jose State up and running in sand volleyball as you did with Bakersfield last year?
Yeah, absolutely. It's the two seasons have mirrored each other in a lot of ways. We see the same things both years. You know, last year with Bakersfield, our players did not really know what to expect. They were all a little bit hesitant going in, wondering what is the sand volleyball all about. And to their credit, they just learned to love the sport, and it's become a huge hit for them because they were courageous enough and adventurous enough to go give it a shot. Our players here at San Jose State in the same boat right now. They're a young team and trying to figure out how sand volleyball works and what it's all about, but they're improving every week and ready to enjoy it.
So you almost maybe get to use this weekend as kind of a learning experience for your team to bring them in to Bakersfield, a program that was in the same boat last year, first year, kind of hesitant, and then bring them into a new facility and a bunch of players that really love the sport now. You can kind of say, you know, this is what you guys should look like in year number two.
That's right. That's a great point, actually. Because right now we are a little bit looking up at everybody. Everybody seems to be more experienced than us and more comfortable out in the sand than us, but we've always emphasized to our teams, you know, watch the players that, you know, have gone before you, learn from them, watch what they're doing, and set a vision for yourself to get there. And we can do that this weekend, and we can see how far Bakersfield has come in the last year with sand volleyball, and we can really set our sights to shoot for that in the future.
Now, you were instrumental in getting things rolling in Bakersfield. How happy are you to be able to return and kind of see it all put together, especially with a facility that I know you were a very big part of?
Yeah, and I have to give credit to my wife, Jolene, as well. She really led the charge on getting sand volleyball in the first place and really sold it to the athletic director, Jeff Konya. Had a great vision for how that could improve our program there at Bakersfield and put us on the map. It was my job to you know, work with the team and train them up and see them go in the right direction. It's really fun to see. We left just as the sand volleyball courts were opening up, just as practice was beginning there at Bakersfield. It was bittersweet to know that we were going to a new place that, that had opportunity, but yet leaving a wonderful team and a exciting facility and season just coming up. So I'm looking forward to coming back and seeing how things have developed, seeing the team, how they've developed in the facility. It's going to be very enjoyable experience, I think, for us.
I was going to say, you brought up it being a little bittersweet. I mean, what kind of – you're probably going to have a few other emotions, right? You got players you recruited that are going to be there, a facility you kind of helped build. I mean, so it's going to be quite a few emotions this weekend, right?
Yeah, I mean, I think for us, you know, in the last couple of years at Bakersfield, you know, our team really became a solid team and worked together. And that's very gratifying to see. You know, I think every coach – out there emphasizes the importance of the team aspect of things and sacrificing of your own self and your own wants. But I think we really saw that take shape with the girls at Bakersfield, and you know, made us really proud to see that happen. And so I have a lot of appreciation for all of their efforts that they all put in to the program. Yeah.
Let's talk about the little bit of the matchup here. I mean, talk about some of your student athletes that make up your squad and what people can kind of expect at a San Jose Sand Volleyball this weekend.
Sure. Well, we got off behind the eight ball a little bit. You know, we had a couple kids slated for surgery right as the season was getting started there, and so a couple of the real impact players for the indoor team here at San Jose ended up needing some surgical procedures and some rest time, some rehab time. And so, you know, at the end of it all, we kind of ended up with only eight players on the roster. So we had to open the team up, and we hosted some tryouts for the student body. And so we have some kids that just want to come out and play and learn the game and have fun with it. And so we have a lot of appreciation for these guys. We have a core of freshmen that, you know, didn't really get much playing time in the fall. And so they're all of a sudden thrown into it. Great, great learning experience for them to just have to battle their way through a brand new situation. And then we have a couple of upperclassmen, I think, that are doing a nice job leading us and lead us, you know, both in mentality and athletically. But overall, we have a pretty young squad, pretty inexperienced squad, and our focus right now is just to keep improving, keep getting better. I think we're going to be we're going to have our hands full with Bakersfield. We're going to have our hands full, especially with USC. But we're going to go out and just use the weekend to look at our game, watch the other players play, compete as hard as we can, and come away with it with a great learning experience.
Now you know the Roadrunners better than anybody. So give us kind of the scout on CESUB and how challenging that they are in the sand, given that you know all these players.
Right. Well, you know, we'll certainly, like I said, compete as hard as we can, and we'll use everything we know about the team to our advantage. But at the same time, you know, they've been training for a good couple months now and improving their game, and they've, I'm sure, expanded their abilities beyond what I remember and what I know about them. So I think they're going to be just fine, and they're in very good hands with Olivia there. And I'm sure that she's really working to bring the program to another level beyond where we left it.
You know, and I want to get your thoughts on this because, you know, you being a volleyball guy, but you kind of get the same sense that I do, you know, getting a chance to see a sand volleyball match in person this past week and seeing it, you know, do you feel that people, once they sort of see it and they see how it's played in person, that they're going to enjoy it more and really enjoy the sport?
I'll tell you, the best thing about the whole thing is just the environment and the vibe you get out on the sand. And it's just a really fun environment for both the players and the fans. A little bit more laid back than and less formal than the indoor game, and maybe closer contact there between fan and athlete. And that's kind of been the situation in all of beach volleyball anywhere in the world. It lends itself to being more fan-friendly. And, you know, there's some folks there in Bakersfield that, you know, Steve Barnes, for one, who's been a great supporter of the program, and some other folks that have just went there, their moral support and their encouragement, they love this stuff. And sometimes beach volleyball is its own community. There's folks there that, unlike myself, who came at it as more of a hobby, you know, to play it in between indoor seasons.
Yeah.
There's folks there that love it to the extent that it's their primary sport, and they know how what a fun sport it can be, and they've loved it for years. And so I'm really happy for that community there in Bakersfield that they can kind of rally around this the program there.
Well, Aaron, I think
and sports program they love.
Absolutely. Aaron, I thank you for joining us on the show, and safe travels back to Bakersfield. I'm sure a lot of folks are looking forward to seeing you this weekend, and good luck to you. We'll see you there.
Thanks so much, Corey. It's great to talk to you.
All right. Aaron Shepardson, now the head coach of San Jose State, returning with his squad this weekend, and the first guy to lead two sand volleyball programs in their first year, and the first guy to be on this show as both a guest in studio and then on the phone and behind enemy lines. It's just how quickly this world evolves. Hey, thanks so much for joining us. You can follow us anytime online at GoRunners.com. You can also check us out on Facebook, Facebook.com/CESUB Roadrunners, or on Twitter and Instagram at CESUB Athletics. Hey, join us next week. We're going to have all sorts of great stuff, highlights, interviews, and of course, Corey Versus is coming back. I promise. Coming back next week. We'll have it next week on Roadrunner Rundown. Thanks for joining us. Get the show anytime online at GoRunners.com. And previous editions available on demand as well. We will catch you next week. Thanks for joining us. This has been Roadrunner Rundown.